Well, you are watching this video, so you like numbers. And I liked numbers since I was very little. And one particular sequence I really loved was powers of 2. So let's start with 1, right? 1 is 2 to power 0, so it has to be here. And then we have 2, 4, 8, 16, 32. And then we keep on going. 128, 256, 5, 112, 1 over 2, 4, 2 over 4, 8. Oops, we ran out of space. Well, let me make things easier and only concentrate on the first digit of these guys. We keep 1, 2, 4, 8, and then we only keep 1, 3, 6, 1, 2, and 5, 1, 2, and so on. So let's collect all this data and put this all together, and that's what we get. Here is the sequence of numbers I'm going to talk about. Let's look at it. The stretch 1, 2, 4, 8, 1, 3, 6, 1, 2, 5, which we had here. Let me mark it like this. And then we see the same stretch. And then we see the same stretch. Very curious. And one more time. And we try to do it one more time, but then there is a little 7. And we have a box here. And here we have 2 things, which are different. And if we keep on going, it happens to be absolutely the same as this one. But if we're here, something else happens. We have an extra 6, which wasn't there before. So the question is what is going to happen in the long run? We have a huge, huge, huge number of these guys. And maybe we can run a little experiment and count how many 1s, how many 2s, how many 3s, and so on. So let's have a little table. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So in the first stage, we have 3 dots here because there are 3 1s, 2 dots because we have 2 2s, and then we have a 3 and a 4, and the 5, and the 6, 8. So 7 is missing, 9 is missing. But then something else starts going on. This is going to change. The question I want to ask is, suppose we have a billion digits. Then do we have more 7s than 8s, or maybe more 8s than 7s? What about 6 or 5s? So how to actually make sense of it?
So will the 7s and 9s make a comeback? Will someone break away and have a lead?
Exactly. We have quite a few 8s here, and 7s or 9s are trailing behind, but maybe we'll spring ahead. And another question is, right, we have a sequence which seemed to be periodic. We have this pattern going on. What if in the long, long, long run we have another pattern, and it'll start go on forever? Well, first of all, let me state the question. I mean, mathematicians, when they state the questions, they sometimes use some notation. Right, you probably got used to it because you watched 100 videos of this channel already. So let me talk. We're talking about let me call it a sub n. N is a natural number, and a sub n is the first digit of 2 to the n. Here we have a sub 0, and then a sub 1, and a sub 4. A sub 2, a sub 3, and so on. Okay, and then we take very big natural number n, and look at the number of little n, say between 0 and n, such that this a sub n is equal to k, where this k could be 1 or 2 or 3 or 4 or 9. Okay, so what is it if n is very big? And specifically, let me take this number and divide by n, and this is going to be the probability you hit 2 if k is 2, or 4 if k is 4. Okay, so out of these numbers, what is the proportion of the ones that have a value k? So you have this huge huge sequence that we saw already, and we can count the number of ones, and that's what I did over there, or twos or threes, and what is going to happen if we increase the length of the sequence? Mathematicians usually say, where does it go to if n goes to infinity? Which means take a very, and here k is fixed. So, for example, k could be 1 or 2 or 3. So that's the question you can ask if you look at the sequence. And some of you have seen a video about the Benford law, and that's the answer, amazingly. So you already know the answer. So what happens is that you have more 1s than 2s, more 2s than 3s, more 3s than 4s.
Even here with our 7s and 9s.
That's right. Eventually, 7 catches up and starts growing, and it beats 8. And this the answer, that we have those numbers, which is logarithm base 10 of 1 plus 1 over k, which is exactly the ones appearing in Benford's law. This log 10 of 1 over k, what does it mean? It means that the number of, well, the proportion of 1s eventually goes to 30.1%, well, approximately. And here we have 17.6%, and here we have 12.5%. And fours get 9.7, and here we have approximate, well, it's not exact figure, it's approximate, and here we have 6.7, 5.8, 5.1, and then 4.6. So it gets smaller and smaller.
Obviously, you're not surprised by this because you're a mathematician, but...
Well, I would say I was surprised by this event initially when it turned out to be the case, but then there's a proof for some surprises.
Like so many of our videos, this was recorded at the Mathematical Sciences Research Institute in Berkeley, California. To see more from this interview, including some more proof, there's a link on the screen and also in the video description. And you can also watch our previous video on Benford's Law.
The probability goes up and up and up through the thousands, and then down through the 2000s, 2005, blah, blah, blah.